What's going on? Tectonic Edge here, playing some more Eldrazi Tron, and we have the die roll. With a... is this a keepable hand? It doesn't do any... A long time ago, I was told to keep a hand that does something earlier than you meant to do it. This does not do that. We have Tron lands, three lands, but it doesn't do anything early, so I think we gotta mulligan that. Okay, it's really good on lands. If we draw into something, it's really good. I think we gotta keep that. We will pitch the... What do we pitch? Warping Wheel is our best answer to something our opponent does. Were there a cure? They're gonna be... Okay. So let's pitch the Dismember. They're gonna be a control deck. I'm not going to be worried too much about creatures. And we're going to present like a Tron deck to start with. Going to feel bad if we draw a Thought Not Seer. Because we could have had turn 2 Thought Not Seer with this hand, but... I'll take a turn 2 Matter Reshaper. That's a held up counter spell if I ever saw one. Bit of a pause here. See if this wastes a counter spell. Of course, I'd rather it land too, but it looks like they're gonna counter. Oh, okay, they're gonna fire it. Ooh, that's a good card for next turn. They still have counter spells. But I'd rather do this. Play this low. Play this for one. Could be about to draw a bunch of cards here. Yep. Well, that was a risk, but one worth taking. If we can land the Reality Smasher, that'll be great, but we've got to time it right. And hit them with as much damage as we can in the in-between. Okay, they put the Orphan Guard in hand. They left themselves with one mana. Feels like we are in a good spot. Because why not? I just remembered we could do this. They haven't really used a counterspell against us, so there's that. And that puts us in a very strong position for next turn. Actually, we just have him dead with the Walking Ballista. Oh, Solitude, yep. Well, Solitude is very helpful at delaying. What did they pitch? Ooh, they pitched the Orphan Guard. Okay. Yeah, interesting tactic. Oof. Battlefield. Although I really would have preferred a land. Let's see if we can top deck a land here. Or a big Eldrazi. Not a land. But we can still go for the Eldrazi on the redraw. Nice, because then we can do this, back this, get another Eldrazi temple. Cast the Mattery Shaper. Not the best spot, but at least we got something out. I think I would have preferred the Yugen, but oh well. That does present lethal and needs to be answered. Alright, spreading seas. That is a good card. Of course we just attack. They're gonna have to do something. I'm betting they have a cryptic command. Or this could just be game and they weren't thinking how they wanted to do something about Lucad. Nope, they're gonna have something. Fire again? No. Okay, they're gonna return it to my hand. And this, and nice. Puts us in a really good spot, because now there are three things they need to answer. At this point, they're just spreading seas to draw cards. And they're gonna scoop. Nice, we put enough pressure. That's a lot of what this matchup tends to be, is putting enough pressure. Let's see, do we make any changes? I don't think we do. Yeah, this could be a slow game. I kind of want the Ulamog over the Relic, right? Yeah, I think that feels right. I am bringing something bigger for something that draws me a card. But I kind of want both big Eldrazi's in case these games run long. And they're control, so they can run long. Still don't want to see either of those cards in my opening hand, but... I'll take Tron. See if they have the answer for this. This hand is very dependent on getting Tron, although if we draw an Eldrazi Temple, we can still turn three a Thought Knot. Oh, okay. Well, ice is effective. And we have to play the land, and they know now if they need to destroy the map or not. Yep. That's a little painful. Oh, and they're gonna bounce it. Yep. Come on, land. Well, that's a land. And that's a land we're gonna take full advantage of with a Thought Knot Seer. Lands, counterspell, draw a card. I think we take their draw effect here. We know they have the counterspell. Alright, we'll see if this baits them. We'll go for the expedition map. Alright, we'll crack the expedition map. Grabbing Cavern of Souls. Won't play the Cavern of Souls quite yet. We'll just play a waste. And we'll go for the Teferi. There's probably an argument for trying to aggro this. Oop, they drew an Archmage's Charm. Okay, they drew more draw. I was trying to keep them off of that. Well, they have a pretty refilled hand here. We draw a power plant. That can be pretty powerful. But then the next two, if this turn's pretty set. Ooh! Alright, well, we know what we're doing next turn. Definitely the Ulamog. But for this turn. And they're probably going to use the dress down here to take away Trample Haste. Or not. And then we get the uncounterable Ulamog next turn. Alright, oh, hard cast the Solitude. Oof. Alright, well, that's a bit unfortunate. Do we go after lands or do we take the Solitude from them? I'd still have four lands, so we'll take the Solitude. Yeah, unfortunately, they had the Spreading Seas. But we have a lot of mana and three really good cards in hand that we can play pretty quick in pretty quick succession. Pretty good use of all his dust there, even if it was for a card that would have gotten rid of the turn. We put them at four life, and they need an answer for Reality Smasher, which they may have, but they also need an answer for Walking Ballista. I think we've got them here. They need a very specific set of cards to get out of this. And that's a lot of mana tap to get out of this. Yep. But we have them dead to the Walking Ballista. We may as well see what they have in hand. And this is GG. Alright, cool. I think they just scooped here. Yep. Alright, well, cool. Thank you for watching. Tectonic Edge here. Signing out.